It's sort of a religious question you're asking, you know, because
I know it, but it's kind of
Because it's sort of the question of like do we need another realm above reality? You know, isn't reality sacred enough? Mm-hmm. You know, and that's really how I think of it. You know, I'm not, you know, bringing things down to some lower level. I'm basically, what I'm saying is, art is as amazing as the world around us. Mm-hmm. I believe the world is sacred. The world is amazing. The world is magical. The world is meaningful. And art is meaningful and as magical as the world as it exists mm-hmm. now. So I don't really think of it in those terms that we're degrading the value of art by putting it in the context of the world. Not at all. And in fact, if you look at how our art galleries have been received by the public, we hired a consultant to ask the public what they thought about what we did. And, you know, there's some concern that people would get confused by mixing all these things together. And in fact, it actually helped the visitors to sort of focus on the art, because there's this statistic in museum research where, regardless of how big the museum is or how small the show is, the public will spend 20 minutes and then they'll leave, because they hit a point of saturation where they just can't look at anything anymore, no matter how big or how small. We found people spending as long as 2 hours in our gallery, and the average time was 45 minutes. And the way, the reason for that, we believe, is because there was a diversity of experience that they encountered, not just painting, or art. There was this sort of, you know, different paces and different kinds of information. So it really created a much more lasting engagement with what we have in the gallery. Mm-hmm. So that was really surprising. We were afraid that it would be confusing, but in fact, it helped people mm-hmm. stay refreshed and engaged. So.
Yeah. And it's interesting to hear you say about that.